Okay, we're here in 2016, and we're at Crown Plaza here, and the head hunters in Barbershop and Smile talking to the owner, March. So how long have you been doing this?
40 years.
40 years?
About 40. 1976, I think.
So I imagine you've seen a lot of change in the neighborhood?
I've seen a lot of change in the neighborhood. Yes, I have.
So what would you sum up as the type of community?
Well, we're in the process of developing the type of community that we're trying to have. They have done a pretty decent job in trying to unite all people together, you know, for us, black and white, different nationalities. So we're just working on that, you know, so far, so good. It's been
good. What would you say is one of the main needs of this particular country, especially the African-American?
Jobs. These kids need jobs. You know, I sit around here and I talk to these kids 24/7. That's my reason for really being down here myself personally. But I got my son-in-law out there, which runs the barbershop. You know, and my primary goal is to come here, talk with these kids, and try to help one, two, three, or whatever I can help. You know, and that makes my day. You know, it ain't about the money no more. It's about trying to give back, you know, and trying to help the community. And that's my main goal right now, my main focus.
And that's important, yeah, to keep involved. Now, we know that through history, verifies that. Two of the main places where especially African Americans love to talk, one is church, the second is the barbershop.
Right.
Now, some of the conversations that should be heard engaged in, one of the things that affects us is our health.
Right.
Because among the many people that are populated in some of this area, we have a high statistic when it comes to high blood pressure,
right,
diabetes, cancer,
right,
and a lot of other lifestyle diseases.
Right.
So by being in this community, you're an example.
Right.
Your facility can also serve as a spot where people meet and they talk. This is why we chose to utilize this particular venue to reach our people, tell them about health, educate them. That's what we're so happy that you allowed us to come out here to understand the barbershop, how we can help our program. So tell me something. How many people did you say that you were a person who had diabetes, high blood pressure, cancer, strong diabetes?
A lot of my cousin right now has cancer, and I'm trying to help him cope with his cancer, you know, I'm trying to encourage him, you know. Basically what I do, I just try to encourage them to stay strong, considering that at the same time, tell them to stay strong. I'm saying, here, don't pay for your haircut, you know, just pamper him as much as I can, you know, go to the hospital to see him, you know. That is my personal good. Other people that come in the shop, you know, I'm still trying to encourage them, you know, stay strong, you know, anything in the world, you know, and do what you can. And I do what I can to help you. I can pick you up and take you somewhere. Don't hesitate to call me and ask me, because, you know, I just feel like that's what I want to do, and that's what I'm going to do. And I don't let nobody distract me from doing that, you know. Even my wife was saying, she'd be calling me, she'd be saying that I try to help too many people. But because a lot of times people misuse you to a certain degree, but just like I just tried to say, all right, I have a role, you know what I'm saying? They only can misuse me as much as I wild into, you know, and I just made me a solid rock, you know what I'm saying? You get a rock, you know what I'm saying? That rock, you ain't hurt that rock, so that little stuff that you're doing don't hurt you. So I try to catch the kids as young as I can to try to work on them, to try to school them, to try to nurse them, to try to, you know, try to get them on the right page. And I have seen good results of some of my work that I have done. These kids that came here and said, man, I thank you for that little pep talk. You never know. You know, but you just spill it out from your heart. It's like you trying to do what you're trying to do and encourage people and talk to people about the cancer and the high blood pressure. And that's the only thing that I have myself personally that I did with just a little bit, but I exercise hard. You know, work out, so of course you don't stay, you know. I keep lines down, so
that's good. I like what you said about being like a rock. And even as a Minnesota in this community, that serves as a focal point for the country. Not only get their haircut, but also get a chance to cut some issues off of their health. And by you giving them the stability and encouragement, especially our young people, especially in today's society, our young men, we need positive role models.
Right.
Barbershop, especially headhunters, served as a role model for the community. And I like what you said about where you were willing to help someone to better themselves or to look ahead. I also noticed that when we came in, I noticed a lot of the artwork that you had in the photos. So, is this family?
Or not, it is my family.
This is family?
Yeah, that's my family. That's my whole family right there.
Okay.
And the big rock is right there. My dad. Yeah, and then the rest of them is, you know, that's up to me. My friends and cousins.
So, the people that you've met over your years have been here in this community, has anyone ever come back, say, a child that's grown up, has come back and visited you?
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, I see that all the time. Oh, I see them out at, you know, I see them out at somewhere to eat, and the dead people say, let me pay for that food. Say, what is that? You know, I have to read. I mean, things like that. And it just happened recently. You know, it happens all the time. You know, I'll be out and they'll be trying to give back. You know what I'm saying? I said, oh, yeah, I remember him now. Sometimes I vaguely remember him, but, you know, he'll be coming back. But they remember me, though. So that's what's important, you know, that they got a hold of things and made things better for themselves. Understand that, you know, even though they was in this environment, you know, your mind ain't got to be in that environment. You know, you still can move your mind. You know, really now with the computers and the internet and all that, you know, you never got to be in a property environment. You know, you can always move. You go to the internet and say, well, this is what I want to do. This is what I want to be. And that's the way I be talking to them. You know what I mean? It's right there before, but sometimes they don't. Nobody nurse them. You know, nobody tell them. I talk to your guys all the time about, hey man, you don't want to have different baby mamas and all that, you know what I'm saying? So when you focus in on, you know, if you have a child, you know what I'm saying, you want to marry this lady, or you want this lady to have your only child, and you ain't getting married to her. You ain't trying to make a whole lot of baby mamas. You know, this is just fatherly things, and sometimes the father might be already told them that, or their uncle, or whoever. But I still put that issue across. And I can tell when they finna go bad, or and I nurse them too, but sometimes, you know, they gonna cross over, but then after they make a mistake, I have seen them go to jail, come back and say, man, you told me this was gonna happen, you know. Well, ain't that in the world, we all make mistakes, you know. Now get back on your feet, do what you gotta do, and tell the next little guy behind you, don't do that, you know, so he gonna make the same mistake you made. So that's the way I be trying to relate to them, trying to encourage them, do what I can.
That's right. I really commend that, especially when you say about you see people. So not only does headhunters cut the head, but you also put some oils and pressure into the head.
Oh yeah,
and that's
all the time. I'm constantly trying to, you know, share wisdom and knowledge with them. Even my money if I have to, you know.
That's right.
And I always let them know, you know, man, if you ain't got no money, just come get a haircut. And I ain't tripping off the money, boy. You know, because you can tell when somebody's being abusive, you know what I'm saying, or something, you know. But these kids are themselves some good kids. But getting back to the point that we need to provide them with jobs, like we did back in the 70s, for somebody they provided me with jobs like that, you know, back in the 70s. Where they get the OJT on the job training, you know, these kids, then if they start working, doing jobs, then the kids that's behind them start seeing them doing good, so that they have somebody to follow. I mean, they don't have no mentors to follow them. They're watching the dope man. The dope man looking good, you know, and making money and doing this here. So they follow him, but they don't know that he gonna go to jail or die, one of the two, you know? And why would you feed somebody something that you don't even want, you know? Or you know that's bad for you. Well, that's not right, you know? But they have a tendency to do that when they get caught up. And then some of them, I think, they promise me they don't be educated, you know? and they can't get that stool in. So instead of them going to rehab school or something to help them and aid the system mentally, they get out here and get caught up with these little dudes that's selling drugs. And they don't want that for real. I'm telling you, man, they don't want that. They want better, but they don't know how to get it, which there's no help out here for them to get it right now. But I'm hoping, you know, through this election or whatever, that these kids be provided with some jobs. And once the black kids and white kids and all kids in general, you know, be provided these jobs, the world will change. And these politicians know this here. That's why they keep you in a stage where they have you at right now, because this is where they want you at, some of them. Now, I ain't gonna say all of them, but some of them gonna keep you right there. So that 1% up there can just nourish everything and keep us fighting over.
So you serve a dual purpose, which is why we're proud to be a part of Headhunters. And those of you who need to have your hairdo, mustache stashed, come Headhunters, your prom project. They see, they curve. Not only that, we have a good haircut or a good hairstylist, we also have some morals, some principles for your head. So we're thankful to be here today, and then we look forward to seeing you all again.
Yesterday, it seemed so clear the way your life should be, but somehow things didn't come around. Confusion leaves you in defeat.
But friend, it's time.
the number one medium that is needed is water. So you're going to pump the hydration from the gas.
Hi ma'am, would you like to get your blood pressure checked for free? Would you like to get your blood pressure checked? You can't help yourself. Okay, you can't help yourself to anything.
I think cameras don't like me. Okay. Okay. Did you want a donation or something for this?
It's all free.
Okay. Okay, my husband texts us out sometimes. Yeah, this is from African Naturals down on South Kings Highway. It's a family owned, but the Nukinis family. It's on Facebook. I bought a lot of stuff from there.
I already got you.
You can delete it. I don't think that's
true.
Have a nice day.
You take care. Thank you for stopping by.
Hi.